Now, we turn our attention to the science behind addiction. People can be addicted to all kinds of things: drugs, alcohol, cigarettes, gambling, even pornography. No matter what the problem is, all addicts have one thing in common: what's happening in their brains. In this segment, we explore the biology and chemistry of addiction and how it hijacks something we all have. Call it our pleasure pathway.
Human beings are designed to feel pleasure naturally in order to survive. Eating keeps us alive. Sex keeps us multiplying.
So all human beings have this pathway in the brain that we commonly refer to as the reward pathway, that basically tells us when we encounter stimuli in the environment which ones we ought to pay attention to, which ones are important for survival. Food and sex are excellent examples of natural things in the environment that activate this pathway.
Similar to how people communicate when one person talks and the other one listens, brain cells also talk. They use chemicals called neurotransmitters, and one of them is called dopamine. It speaks the language of pleasure. When the reward pathway is activated, dopamine is sent from one cell and received by the next.
It's this neurotransmitter dopamine, this chemical signal, dopamine, that's released and transmitted through the pathway that lets the organism know that this is a pleasurable thing.
The chemicals and drugs basically commandeer the brain's reward pathway. Instead of natural little bursts of dopamine, drugs create a surge, hitting the brain like a bolt of lightning. Doctors believe the same sort of process occurs with certain behaviors, like compulsive gambling. Be it from gambling or drugs, the brain tries to adjust to abnormally high levels of dopamine, and things go haywire. Important connections are lost. Fuses are blown, so to speak. The brain loses its normal ability to process dopamine, and the addict loses a baseline ability to feel pleasure. He or she must continue the harmful behavior just to feel normal. Advancements in scanning technology now allow researchers to actually visualize these chemical changes inside the brain. This is a healthy brain. The red color indicates normal brain chemistry in the reward pathway. And here's the brain of a heroin addict. The absence of red indicates, in a sense, the blown fuses due to drug abuse.
Repeated drug use damages other areas of the brain too, such as those involved in judgment and self-control. And while anyone can become addicted, some people are more genetically prone to it than others. That's why addiction tends to run in families. One other important note while we're focusing on the brain: drug and alcohol abuse is particularly problematic for teens because their brains are still developing. Addiction not only messes with their brain chemistry, it also stunts their emotional growth. This program is part of Ideastream's ongoing multiple media health information series called Be Well. Watching this show, you may realize you need help or know someone who does. Go to health.ideastream.org, where you'll find a library of news stories, journal articles, and studies about addiction. You can also call United Way 211. Just dial 211 to be linked to services in our region that can help you, your family, or a friend.